She said to me, don't you feel any conviction over these things?
I was very much in control of my own life, and I didn't want, you know, anyone telling me how to live my life.
I was that sinner, and that I needed his forgiveness.
I thought I was good to go. I didn't think that I had any problems.
Then someone say, well, but you made this choice. You did this or you did that.
But if we don't have that joy from God, if he's not our chief joy, then you'll not impact the lives of others.
But if you are lost, you are presently lost, and you will be forever lost.
I didn't, because of pride and fear.
I'd go back on Monday back to school, and it was same as usual.
It was the first time that I really sat down and started reading the Bible.
Trying to know God, but it was really only for my own convenience, and I was always trying to earn a salvation.
For many years, I didn't attend any churches.
And I just felt God like pull on my heart, like I don't have that, you know, I'm not living for him.
And so, once again, I struggled for the last 8 years with that negative influence.
The Lord, the God of Israel, is the one true God.
He is our general, he is our captain, he is our king.
In saying to all of you here today that Christ is the only way.
You can press somebody to place their faith in Jesus, but only God can convince them that they need to do so.
And I sat there, and I'm like, wow, that is me. Because I have my whole life honored God on my lips. But I truly don't think I had him in my heart like I should.
Instead of, like, turning towards anger, I just go to Christ, and I pray.
I asked Christ to come into my heart.
And I realized that I had not seen myself as a sinner until that very point.
My sin needed to be punished, and Jesus freely took that punishment upon himself.
You change the hearts and everything else changes.
And I texted back that I was ready to accept him wholeheartedly.
Since that day, I've felt this joy in my heart, overwhelming joy that I have never felt before.
It was to the song, Behold Our God, and it just wiped me away.
Working with them, now I enjoy reading the Bible.
I want to follow and serve God over everything else, and that nothing else will ever satisfy like what God does.
And on the 20th of January, I declared that Jesus is my Savior, that he died for my sins.
And for the first time in my life, I looked into people's eyes, and it wasn't fake.
And so after that, we prayed, and this time it wasn't just a prayer, it was really something that was true.
My redemption has nothing to do with my good deeds.
Whoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
I wrote the word reconciled down on my piece of paper, and I felt it. And I felt free and unburdened and so happy, and I felt shame no more.
The enemy has feasted on my sins and on my weaknesses, but no more.
Amen.
Drugs, alcohol, pornography, immorality, fight! Fight against these things! Fight against your flesh!
God really used that, and he pierced my heart.
Even though I heard this many times before, it's like I had never heard it before.
It is one of the most freeing experiences of my life.
Right after I got saved, I really did feel different.
I knew now that it's my faith.
But they are growing in you day by day.
I felt my heart just pulling, just tugging, and I jumped on it. I said, yes, and can we start tonight?
You need to go to Christ in these hard times and lean on him, because there is a reason.
But God, when he saves us, he does it oftentimes by taking us through very humbling circumstances. God is in the business of saving people. That's what he does. He brings glory to himself by bringing others to himself.